And finally for today, aside from just becoming more comfortable with the command line, we also want to start looking at how you compile and run C programs. So here is your very first C program. It's sort of the typical hello world program. So you can you should practice creating a file on Stu once you've logged in. Call it hello.c and go ahead and type in this program so that you can try to compile and run it. As described in your textbook, so this is a figure from your textbook, this is the compilation process for C. So there are actually several steps that your program goes through before it becomes a program that you can run. It goes first through a preprocessor, then a compiler, then an assembler, and finally a linker. And we'll talk more about this later. But for now, there is one command here that you can run that runs the entire tool chain. So you just run gcc, which is the new GNU C compiler. And then you tell it that you want the output file to be called hello, and the input file is going to be hello.c. And that's going to take hello.c and run all these steps. It won't actually create all these intermediate files. You can if you want to. There are some command line options that let you do that. But for now, just go ahead and generate the final resulting executable, which then you can run with the command ./hello. The compilation process is actually usually streamlined using something called a build system. So we'll use a build system called make this semester. And the way this works is that you provide a text file that contains all of the individual commands for compiling and linking the project. And then you can, the benefit of this is that you can then run the entire build using a single command. You just type make and it automatically does anything that it needs to in order to build the program. And if you change the source files, then it will recompile the program if you type make again. So here's an example make file that's appropriate for building that Hello World application. So here we have a target called hello. It has one dependency, the hello.c, and then here is the command that is used to build the file. And note that this needs to be a tab right here. So if you create a file and you put this in it, the file needs to be called makefile with a capital M. And once you have that, then you can just type make and it will build your Hello World example. So to finish today, you should go ahead and do the compilation lab. This will help you become, again, more comfortable with the command line and with how C programs are built. You should go ahead and read through the project guide for this course. So all of the projects in this course have the same basic framework, even though each project is a little bit different. And so the project guide contains instructions about how to work with the projects in general. And there's a lot of really important information in that project guide. And so you really do need to spend the time to read through that guide carefully and maybe take some notes on it. And I really highly encourage you to experiment with the project framework. So, you know, poke around and look at things. My intention is that by the end of the semester, you should be able to understand everything that's happening in this framework. So there shouldn't be anything that is opaque or that doesn't make sense to you anymore. And so I really encourage you to poke around and play with it and try to get to the point where you understand everything that's going on with the projects. And then finally, you should go ahead and skim the Project Zero description. So this is the first project in this course, so computer scientists like numbering things starting with zero. So this is just an introduction to C programming. It doesn't really have anything to do with the rest of the projects in this course. It's just a sort of a way for you to learn C and experiment with the project framework a little bit. Don't panic as you read the project description. There are probably a lot of things in there that you're not familiar with and that you're unsure how to do at this point. And that's totally fine. There's no need to finish this immediately. The goal is to learn C while you're working on this project. So you'll work on the project incrementally over the next couple of weeks as you learn more about C and its differences from Java. So it's kind of a good framework for exercising all of the new topics from C as we cover them in the course.